Michael Ichihara. I'm an assistant professor at the Kansai Gaida University in Osaka, Japan. There are two characteristics in Japan's democracy support. One is that most of the support goes for introduction or further facilitation of market economy. And another is that most of the aid provided for democracy support in the case of Japan is through the state institutions, not through civil society. The top policy concern for Japan is apparently Asia. That's the place where the power game between China and Japan is getting ever intensifying. Asian countries in Japan share this concern over the maritime security facing greater threats from China. In addition to it, in Asia, we have a lot of countries which had democratic openings since the mid-1980s. And so, that's the top policy concern. When it comes to a particular country, currently Myanmar or Burma is the country where Japan places importance on. Myanmar started the liberalization process in 2012, and so the window of opportunity is now open for further liberalization or possibly democratization. I would say that there is a division of labor, de facto division of labor, between Japan and those, the United States or European Union, European countries. One is that Japan tends to provide huge monetary support for democracy support, whereas the United States, European Union, and European countries send technical assistance as well. Another division of labor I see is that Japan supports democracy through state institutions, such as Japan provides capacity building assistance to central governmental or local governmental officers, whereas the United States or European countries provide support through the civil society as well. Japan started emphasizing democracy support increasingly in the mid-2000s, from the mid-2000s, especially under the Abe administrations. The motivation is in Japan's increasing power game with China in Asia. But yet, when it comes to the substance of Japan's democracy support, there is not much difference compared to the past. Because Japan has to make its democracy support more attractive compared to China's inducements. And so Japan cannot take too much coercive measures to those governments that are not affirmative of taking democratic reforms.